Hi. Can I stand here? Okay, so before I start, I guess this is the only event whereby the speakers, right, the three of us, will ask everybody to take out their phone and try their bots. So this is probably the only event whereby you can take out your phone. You're encouraged to do it and start, you know, tapping away or anything. Just try not to WhatsApp each other, all right? Okay, so anyway, thanks for everyone coming. I see, get to know some new friends already just now. And I think it's pretty amazing. I see a lot of young people. Anyone here still studying? Just a show of hands. Oh my God. Anyone here not studying already? Anyone feel old? How old are you, sir? 28. Oh my God, and you're old. Do you know that Alex is older than you? Okay. Okay, so anyway, we are all fun-loving people. I guess the reason why we spend our Friday night here is to learn something new about bots, right? So we have to try to keep it more alive. Hope the pizza doesn't make you sleep too much, all right? So I recall my days when I was still studying. So at night I was doing grey hat hacking, if you know what that means. Right, grey hat hacking means I'm a legal guy, but I try to be legal. I'm a legal guy trying to be, you know, trying to do some things that are not so legal, but actually it's legal, you see. Yeah, like trying to game the SEO system. I'm sure some of the hackers will do that as well. So that's the background that I came from. Then I built websites for my friends for free last time. I didn't know it was a business. So my friends came over to me like, Leon, I got this idea, can you help me to build? So quite stupid lah. You should charge them money, you see. But I just built. So in that sense, so I learned quite a bit. Okay, but anyway, so I'm not here to talk about my past life as a web guy. I'm here to share more about our bot story and how we started off. So Aitomon is a pretty new company. We just incorporated last year, September 2016 only. Okay, so I'm here to share with everyone about our journey, some of the products we have along the way, and the story that we have to tell. Okay, so are you all ready? Yes, okay. So as I was mentioning, I was like a web guy all the while, web and trying to explore some iOS technologies here and there. But then this thing caught my eye. Okay, this thing caught my eye. I saw this graph, no? It says that the monthly active users in messaging apps like exceeds the number of monthly active users in social networks. So that really caught me. So it says something about messaging. More people are using that. And what's more, Facebook's Messenger has reached 1 billion users since last year. And then Facebook launched their chatbot platform last year. Okay, so that was the, you know, the like a young boy falling in love one more time. Every time something new launched, right, what do you do? I mean, some of us are enthusiasts. Even if you can't code, you'll try to read out about it because you're interested in technology or you find it on some TechNager or E27 thing. So that's what I did as well. So all the while, you know, when I was running my previous company, I wanted to get in somehow. Okay, so my previous company was also with Alex. It's called EventPath. Okay, so EventPath is like Uber for temp hiring. It's still alive, don't worry. Okay, and so some of the customers we serve are like C-Delhi, British High Commissioner. So we use the Uber model, but we try to link it with a part-time job. So it's a simple matching model. But rather than just do the regular job bot posting, so what we did was we try to connect people through the mobile app, and then they can pay through the app everything. Okay, but to grow this marketplace, right, it requires a lot of intensive effort. Okay, so what Alex did at a period of time was every day he had to do a lot of manual work, literally sit in front of a computer, go to Gumtree, or go to JobStreet, right, and try to suck all their traffic into our app. You know, so he posts all the ads there, he try to contact people, say that, hey, you know, come and come to our app, it's better, it's faster and everything. So it came to a point where Alex told me this. 5 hours of manual work a day, what the fish? Okay, so he told me that. I was quite surprised because Alex is a really hardworking guy. All right, so every day he's no complaint until one fine day in a WhatsApp group, he tell me, like he's going to die, you know, that kind of feeling. He's going to jump off a building if he has to do more manual work, more posting, more customer service. So that was a light bulb moment. Okay, so I told him that let's stop the madness together, shall we? Ding ding. So what we did was we tried to explore this thing called automation. We tried to automate the work that we are doing. So instead of we manually posting in Gumtree, right, we tried to use bots, right, to crawl the web and start to post things. And then we find that that's a pretty cool idea. So we tested on other companies. We asked our friends, those who run marketplace, how do you get your traffic? They say they literally hire people from all over the world, try to pull some traffic in. Then we say, if you can help me to automate this, will you be interested? They say it's a no-brainer. So long as it's cheaper than their employee, of course. So it's a no-brainer kind of thing. So what we did is straight away, we gathered a team to, you know, work on this new idea straight away. So we gather our core team, and then the next step is to find customers, correct? Every new startup, what you try to do is you try to find customers straight away. So we all find big customers or small customers to test your idea. Which are big or small? Small. we didn't. We go really big. Okay? Don't know whether that's the right thing or bad thing. So our first customer last year, within like 1 month after we launched, right, we spoke to GIC. We got them interested in automation services. So GIC is a government investment corporation in Singapore, right? I don't think there's anyone here, hopefully. Yeah, so they're a really big company, right? There's an NDA, but I'm not going to talk about anything, okay? So basically, we help them to automate a lot of their processes. Help them to save a lot of time, save a lot of money, save a lot of resources, so they can better deploy their resources elsewhere, okay? So some of the examples we did, it's generic, don't worry, so you can capture it by camera. For example, is this. So we did this thing called a desktop automation. That's how our enterprise bots thing started. So this is a typical company's invoicing process, right? Many steps, so complicated, right? So they hire a lot of people to do this. So we came into them, we showed them this. Before is this, after is this. Before is this, after is this. One more time, Before is this, after is this, okay, yeah. So we reduced, you can count, the number of steps, that the reduction of steps from 15 steps, to 4 steps. The rest are all done by bots. So it greatly improves their productivity, you see. And at the same time, the employees, they don't get fired, obviously. Yeah, it's not like I automate a job and I fire you, right? So I automate a job and I'm going to give you a higher level job, something that's more creative rather than mundane. So that helped the company. And then we went on to prove more things. Okay, so after that, the next thing we want to prove is it can work on the back end. Can it work on the front end? So we tried to automate customer service, right? I think you all read a lot in the news, there's a lot of this automating of customer service coming in. So I'm going to show you all one bot that we built on Twitter. Let's play a slide video. Okay, so this is an example of the bot. So this is my account. So what do people do on Twitter the most? They tweet, yeah. What do they tweet about? Okay. So they usually tweet negative things, right? I mean, how many of y'all read positive tweets in Twitter? Okay, so I was one of those guys, literally. For example, let's look at this. This is what people do. Can y'all see? This is arbitrary, meaning that it's not true. Okay, so people like me, once I take a taxi or take a transportation, if it's no good, what will I do? I will go to somewhere, I'll tell my friends, I'll try to tell people about it, right? So I say this, Grab car sensor, okay, maybe we should take Uber. So imagine the moment I hit tweet, what happens? The moment I hit tweet, my tweet goes out to the world, negative PR, agree? So the difficulty of companies usually is how to control the PR as much as possible. In the quickest period of time, how to reach out to your customer, tell them sorry, and we are going to fix it for you. Agree? So the traditional way is you go manually, you hire customer service, you go into the Twitter box on top, the search box, and then you try to type your company's name every day. Some of the big companies do this. They type their company every day, or they have the live monitoring like on Hootsuite or Buffer, right? Then they try to monitor the thing. So they realize that's not very useful because it's not real time enough. You can only track, but you can't respond back. So we built an autoresponder, okay, that does this. You see, the moment the negativity comes out, within how many seconds? 3 seconds. Okay, obviously we don't put it at 3, it's too fake, right? Okay, so we put it probably 10 seconds, you can adjust it. So we tell them this. See what we say over here? Grab told me, hey Leon, we are sorry. Is there anything we can do to make up for it? Amazing. Imagine today you quarrel with your boyfriend or girlfriend. On the spot, you can fix the thing with her. You can read her emotions straight away. How do you think she'll feel? You see, so that's the power of bots. In real time, you try to reverse the situation. When the customer is at their weakest point, you try to reach them. And this can only be done by bots, right? Because it's virtually impossible for a human to sit there 24/7 and try to, it's just not worth the time. Use it in bots. Because this is our first use case. Okay. Oh, wait, there's one more use case. How do I forward this? Shall we see it one more time? Can't seem to forward this. So this is more of the defensive barrier, right? So your customers are angry, you try to make them happier. Now how about if your competitors have unhappy customers, what do you want to do with them? Your competitor has unhappy customers, yes, you try to convert them. We try to bring them over to your site, right? So this bot can do that as well. It's the same technology, just think out of the box and then we can have a different use case entirely. Okay, so this one is a simple case of customer recovery. Customer is happy, your cost of customer acquisition goes down, lifetime value increases, all this business stuff. Okay, good. So the next example is to go and acquire other people's customer. Now we're going to see how to do it in a legal way, all right? In a white hat way. You see, now we say, My Republic is so slow. Oh my god. How many of y'all felt this way when y'all used internet before? If y'all never felt this way, y'all never use internet, right? Okay? So what happens is, look, if the competitor comes in, another telco comes in and say, hey, I'm going to give you a discount code now. You strike the customer at the right time. I mean, that's what some companies try to do, right? But they can't do it at that moment. But with bots, you can. Right, with bots, you can. So at that moment, obviously, you don't put it as 2 seconds again. You put it as 20 seconds. Now, within 20 seconds, if your internet crashes, you'll be so pissed off, right? That your chance of converting is pretty high, if you think about it. It's just a science thing. So that's how we have this use case as well. It's on Twitter. Okay, so now if you type any negativity, y'all can try. Don't worry, we're off the board. We're off the board already, so you can't try. Yeah. Okay, so this is for big companies, right? Because you want to automate every single thing. Front end, back end. And then after that, we went on the next journey. We went to hunt for small company use cases. So now we've got a big company. We try to automate everything, make the cost cheaper, reduce their, increase their productivity. And then we go to small businesses. Okay, how many of us here has a friend that runs small business? Or you yourself are running a small business? I'm sure there is, right? Yeah, okay. So what do small businesses need the most? It's just one simple thing only. Big companies want to reduce their cost, right? Small companies want to increase their... Yes, increase their sales. So we set out to find another way how to help companies increase their sales using bots. Another simple analogy, okay? So now this is what we did. And this is a real use case. This is something that helped us. Okay, now let's look at the video. So remember, like I told you all just now that Alex was the one going on Gumtree trying to bring over the traffic. Now you're going to see what Alex does 1,000 times faster. Okay, so let's have a look. So this is bot, this is not Alex. Alex can't type this fast. You see, bam, whoa, boom. It starts sending things, can you see? The bot starts to curate, starts to find all the necessary things, necessary ads out there. Let's see again, it's too fast. Oh. How do I do it? Okay. Okay, now look at the right-hand side. See, the thing is typing by itself. So my mouse is not moving, can you see? But the software is running by itself. So we're scraping the web and then going to all the relevant people that is involved. Then we're telling them that, look, see, all these are the HR companies that are our target, right? So rather than post on Gumtree, so we decide to reach out to them on a 1,000 times kind of speed. Then we tell them, look, come to our platform. It's much easier, it's much faster. And this is how we help ourselves to increase our sales, right? So that's the best way. Now, think about different use cases. With this same technology, you can apply it, for example, if you have a friend that runs a web development firm, a simple company, right? Just build websites for other people, just like myself probably, okay? So what happens is we tried it on our sister company, Khaki Builder. So they have real results as well. So before that, they spend a lot of manual work trying to generate leads online. So they go to other places, they go to Facebook, they try to find places where people look for websites, and they try to bring the traffic over. So before that, they spend 20 hours a week to generate 10 leads, which is actually not bad, but it's all done by human. All right, so one of our guys will be every day sitting at the computer, trying to talk to people online, try to answer the queries and everything. But after putting in this bot, let's look at the productivity increase. After 1 week, sorry, in the same week itself, we just tried. So 1 hour now generated 45 leads. You do some simple math, see the increase? 450%, simple. So these are just some of the use cases that a bot can do for large companies and small companies, very simple, okay? But it didn't stop there. Okay, so the adventure carried on. So now we find big companies, we already find small companies. We prove that this technology can help people. We make a bit of money. But to us, money is not the most important, correct? Because the most important thing is you have to solve a problem for people and then there's more things at the back for you to take. So what we did is we went to research about this whole industry, how this AI thing becomes so popular in like with the recent year, how these chatbots things start to take over, all the media and everything. So we find one interesting fact that we like to share nowadays. Have you all heard before? Singularity. Singularity, this term. Anyone heard before? Please don't be shy. Well, 1, 2, 3. Singularity, come on. Anyone? Maybe a 3-4% market share here, okay, of people who know singularity. Now, what is singularity? Very interesting. You see the chart over here. Just look at the 2040. So this scientist, Ray Kurzweil, in 2005, he said that by 2040, all right, machine intelligence is going to exceed the collective intelligence of human being. Ah. So you all know as Skynet, right? So this is the negative Skynet thing, lah. Okay, Skynet is basically singularity, but the negative part of it. So it's the same idea, but it's to tell people that we should be prepared for the revolution that is coming. It's going to replace some of our jobs. You know, some people are afraid and not. But for us, we take it positively because in every technological change, there's always opportunity. Okay, so some people act on it. So we went dig further, no? We go and find people that really, you know, they put money where their mouth is, no? They say it's gonna happen, they bet on it. So this guy, Masayoshi, you all know Alibaba, right? Yahoo, all this early investor in them. Okay, so Japanese here, I think all the idols of this guy. So he said that the biggest paradigm shift in human history is singularity, and it's gonna come in this lifetime. So what I did is he bought a chip company to prepare for the change, you know, the IoT, Internet of Things, all right? Connect all the devices together. So he bought the whole company for $32 billion. Now you think about it, if someone of his level that has achieved so much in his life already also want to bet on this trend, he's not resting on his own, right? He should have retired, like what he said. But he's coming back to the ground and trying to push this AI, push this singularity notion forward. So it gave us a lot of inspiration, right? So we set out to solve an even bigger problem, right? So now we don't just want to solve big company problems, small company problem. We want to solve a problem that is really huge. We try to identify things that can touch everybody as much as possible. Okay? The big problem. Now what do we do next? So we go back to ideation stage, correct? Then we try to build a product. Have y'all seen this before? When y'all think of ideas, I'm sure y'all will think of this, right? Like, what business can I start that other people confirm use on? Y'all will think of this, right? So every day you do ideation, then you start to code. Yeah, but before you code, you need to do some ideation. So in our opinion, right, it's very simple. If your business is closer to this chart, right, to the low of this chart, the more essential your product is. Just look at Airbnb and Uber. They're touching transportation and the way people live, correct? So this is as low as possible. Your security needs. If you sell food, well, even worse, right? I mean, there's a lot of food startups nowadays, food delivery. So it just proves one thing, that if you are closer to the Maslow's hierarchy of needs, they call it, all right, as you go higher, it's more, you're more zen, basically, right? You've achieved self-actualization. Okay, that works as well. You can build a business around it. But the larger business that you can build is something that is closer to this. Okay, that is why Bus Uncle probably works so well. Because it's transportation, right? So everybody needs transport. So everybody has to find a better way every day to get to the transportation timing. Okay, so now, in the past 1 month, for those of us who have met in Bots Meetup number one, we said that we will try to think of this idea and try to launch it. So if you are here again, you're going to see us really launch this thing. Okay, so we put money where our mouth is. We put effort, you know, where our mouth is. And then we are trying to solve this problem now. So what's the problem? This thing. Something that we believe that touch everybody, right? Any of you all don't make any decisions every day. You just live the day, you know, like going by. Even if you wake up, you also have to make a decision, right? Brush your teeth is a decision, okay? So now humans, we realize, make an average of 30,000 decisions a day. And we did a lot of like research, you know. And we find out that there's no easy and fast way to make daily decisions. So we needed to create something that's so easy for people to use that you can literally outsource your decision. Right? Because when singularity comes, we believe that most of the people won't be making hard decisions anymore, correct? Most of it will be left to robots. So we wanted to start now. We wanted to reverse engineer and create a bot that can help people to make easy decisions. Okay? For example, like what? Things that y'all will face every day. Okay? See before? Wear this or that? Eat this or that? Nowadays, very hip. Profile pic this or that? I'm sure y'all face all this, right? Okay? Consumer problems. How about business problems? Recently, SGAG. Okay, y'all read SGAG, right? They changed their logo, then y'all see the video down there. Like the designer has a headache, you know, trying to change their logo, everything. Now, we wanted to solve this problem for them, you know? Right? That's why we think, okay, it's kind of a product market fit thing. Next one, another problem. Simple daily decisions, right? Like what promo code do people like? That's why the taxi bot people can succeed, right? Right? It's simple daily decisions, daily decision making. You all know this one? Before I carry on, anyone from either of these startups was? Shopee. Yeah. Shopee. You use Shopee? You're from Shopee?
No.
You're from?
I know the product.
Sorry?
I know the product.
You know the Shopee?
Yeah. Right.
Okay, good. Yes, and okay, if you run a small business, you all got friends that run cafe, right? You can ask them how they launch their product. It's also really quite difficult. They need to do a lot of market research, correct? Connoisseur. So they post on Facebook, they post on Instagram. You know, usually people like that. I don't know whether it's to attract attention or is it really has a business use case, but it works. So your friends will post their picture, you know, like, what should I wear? OOTD, hashtag, right? Yeah, I'm sure you all see a lot of this. Or like the business owner posting like, I have a new logo, I need decision making, I need help. If you go LinkedIn, there's a lady that nowadays she keep posting, which one should I use my book cover? Which photo should I use for my book cover? So these are little decisions that we try to automate as much as possible and put into a bot as simple. Okay, and that's why we came out with this. Our bot is called Ask Sora. The girl that you see in front, all right, is this one. Now, Ask Sora is a chatbot platform that allows users to post two images and get crowdsourced comparisons votes in as fast as 5 minutes. So it's pretty simple. If you all got a phone, you all can take it and use. 3 steps, you snap 2 pictures, you just ask a question and then you post, and then people will come to vote. So at this stage, it's pretty simple. There's no Microsoft Louis API behind. There's no Facebook, you know, your Wheat API behind. There's nothing yet, okay? Then we'll see how. So we think of Ask Sora as a scalable focus group in the cloud. So we just launched the product like yesterday. So if you all can help us to test, you'll be more than grateful, okay? As alpha testers, not even beta testers. Okay, prime testers, meaning they haven't even reached alpha stage. Okay, so some of the results we got, some people post very interesting stuff, which we want to share with you. So some people post this. Y'all know these two people? Who don't know the right-hand guy? The younger people may not know the left-hand one, right? Li Jiawei, she used to play, she's still, you know, with the table tennis in Singapore. So you want to guess how many people vote for the right-hand side guy, Joseph Schooling? Minority or majority? Yeah, definitely. Like, it's only how much, right? Okay, so you see over here. So the idea is within an instant, you can get opinion. All right, next one. Ah, this one, the one that you know. Now, you want to make a guess who has higher votes? Or well, you're biased, no? It's on recording, you know, beware. Next time, you cannot find job there. At Shopee. Okay, 55, 45. Okay, interesting. Last one. Make a guess. Make a guess. Apple mouse versus Razer mouse. I don't know who posted this, but the results, I was expecting the opposite. Let's see. I mean, I thought Apple is like one of the world's largest brand kind of thing, right? Because I'm not too gamey, not too gamer kind of guy. Okay, so now what we want to do is to share with you the real life app sample, shall we? The app demo. Then we can have a look. The chatbot demo. You take out. Yeah. So we just launched this. It's on Microsoft Bot Framework for real. So it's a pretty easy to use Bot Framework, and we are hosting on Heroku in case you are interested. Okay. Heroku's free plan. Startup, you know, we have to try to use as many things as free as possible, right? So if it crashes, please don't blame us. We will upgrade it in the shortest period of time, all right? Okay, let's see.
Yeah, let me start from the beginning. So this is Messenger, right? Everyone has Messenger. Just add us. So
if you all have a mobile phone with you now, we will appreciate if you all try also. But if too many people try, I think more than 7, right, in the usual free server kind of thing, will crash. Yeah. But please try. We will appreciate it. Okay. Have a look. So, okay, anyway, now it's open to the public in an alpha form. So if you want, you can really literally post stuff inside it. So we get a lot of pretty interesting things, like people posting Cai Sun Ye versus Santa Claus. We don't know what value this has to some people, but apparently it does. Important enough for them to start posting. Okay, we have MOA, MLM company is also here as well. We get some Donald Trump versus this guy. You want to make a guess first? Well, who guessed Trump? Don't forget, there's a recorder here. Okay, let's see. Oh, yes, so it's Trump. You guys are correct. The recorder works, okay? This guy also, oh my God. I wonder who posted this, man. This guy. Who will y'all choose? We don't know, okay? How about we choose people? Human like to vote on other people, right? Very judgmental nowadays, youngsters also, right? Used to be the older you are, the more judgmental. Now the younger you are, the more judgmental. Yeah, so the guys will start to vote on this, I swear. Okay? when we launched this, right, a few hours ago, we thought it was meant to be like people, like, you know, like literally you vote on people, like your favorite CEO or your favorite your mother versus father. You see a lot of these things over here, right? So we know who our user base is straight away, right? It's got to be the younger generation, I think. Yeah, it's quite cool. Yeah, I agree. Oh my god. And then there's certain things quite cool, like we have people posting like really what you want to wear, so they hold two things. So they say, I'll buy the item that you vote more. Whoa, so they value the public view, correct? Or in Singapore, we like to eat, right? So there's a lot of food pictures as well, so pretty interesting. It's like a new version of Instagram that people take and start to post. And the best part about this whole thing, right, is the results are pretty interesting. Okay, I posted my face to try also. So I posted one really, I think it's not bad looking one. Okay, a lot of Photoshop done on by my graphic design friends. Another one, no Photoshop. You know, looks ugly. To my opinion. End up, you know which one won? Natural. Because natural beauty pays off. Okay, so that's what I learned through my own product also. Pretty interesting exploration. Food one. Okay. We have actually one designer that really posted, he works with certain clients. Like they want to, you know, so he does A/B testing, you know, in marketing, right? Yeah. Well, this is let's not vote this. Okay, so I think that's about it for the demonstration, right? Oh, now we're gonna do a live one, live posting. Oh my god, are you gonna vote against me, bro? I can't take the results now. Who's better looking? Damn. These are moments when I feel like I shouldn't start this business. I shouldn't start this startup again. Anyway, as you can see, it's really easy to upload your choices. I don't know, I see some, you know, have you all heard of this app called Meitu? And Snow. Actually, I didn't know all this. I'm not too photo filtery kind of guy, right? But because people upload it, then I see there's a tag inside that says Meitu. So I'm gonna try. It's like amazing. You can, there's some AR or some machine vision thing that can, you know, scan your face, and then put cool stuff on there. And then I mean the messenger platform allows you to share within your app as well. So when I use Bus Uncle, I also shared the app like crazy using the function that's inside. It's a really useful app as well. And that's it. So if you all come across this piece, you all know which one to vote, right? Okay, amazing. Okay, anyway, so that's all for our demonstration. Okay. Ooh, my time is almost up, so I'll do a quick round off. Oop. Again. The final slide, all right? So in summary, what do we do, okay? Number one, SG Bots, the event that everybody is here. So we started this as a non-profit kind of thing, right? Like how Michael started all the engineering groups as well. So he's here to help, to record as well. Yeah. So we started off this because we wanted to find people that really want to get involved in bots. Because bots are pretty new, like less than 1 year old technology. So we wanted to find people that are interested to code themselves or build a business around bots. So it happened that this event helped us to find a lot of partners as well. People that come to us, tell us they want to build a bot, or people that come to us say that they want to hire people that can build a bot. So some of the networking thing that happens over here really do happen offline after that. Like people really get jobs through this bot event. So that's our, we actually, you know, hit a bit of our goal, okay? Lead Gen is the product that you've seen just now. The one that start blasting everybody in sales, it's an automation software. Asora is our chatbot, okay? SG Chatbot is an initiative that we created using a, it's a simple, low-cost bot building solution that we actually use Q&A Maker. Q&A Maker.ai is a Microsoft product. It's really good also. So it helps you to build Q&A for your own small business or your own big business, doesn't matter, in like lightning speed. So you just have to upload the thing, then you build. So we use that framework. And if you don't want to do it yourself, we have partners that actually will do it for you also through this SG chatbot as well. Okay, and lastly is if you run a big company, you want to speak to us and find out about automation or what, you can come and speak to us. We'll refer you to the correct sister company that we work with. Okay? All happy? If not, thanks for listening to my 20 minutes of speech. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, so usually